Good morning. Good morning, and welcome to First Church of God in Christ. Truly, this is another day that the Lord has made, and we are certainly excited to rejoice and be glad in this. We thank God because He's allowed us to make it to another Sunday. Y'all, we've survived another week, another day.
We are
towards the end of September, by God's grace, going into a new month.
Yeah.
So we have something to be thankful about. Can we just stand up and give God praise for allowing us to make it to the last Sunday of the month? Hallelujah. And we just want you to know, you may be seated. You're at a church where everybody is somebody, and you are with family.
Yes.
We believe that there is a word from the Lord for you today. And so we hope that as much as you put in it, that's what you'll get out of it.
That's
so we hope that you will engage with us today. At this time, we will have opening prayer by one of our outstanding missionaries, Missionary Lois McIntyre, and after which we will have scripture by Elder Scotty Welch.
Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
My God.
That's the spirit of the season right now.
Right now.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All my hallelujahs belong to you.
Oh, they belong to you.
Lord, we give you all the glory.
Hallelujah. Hey.
All the honor.
Hallelujah.
All the praise.
Yes, we give it to you.
We reverence you in the name of Jesus.
God.
Hallelujah. We bind everything that's not like you. Lord, you brought us through this dilemma, this storm.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
Lord, and I know just when the storm was raging on the sea, you said, peace be still.
You said it. You said it.
Lord, we need that power.
Right now. Lord.
We need that authority of the Holy Ghost to say, peace be still.
My Lord.
Lord, you brought us back. You kept us safe. Hallelujah. Without this pandemic in our lives, in our homes, you protected us. But you know, Lord, I still said I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's seek the Lord as we never have done before.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We're living in the last of the last days. And Lord, we're just going to thank you for right now.
Right now, yes.
Just one day at a time, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
your goodness and your mercy, your will, your way. Hallelujah. To dying on the cross for us. And we praise you. Seek the Lord with all our hearts, oh God. Help us to seek you as never before.
Yes.
Hallelujah. No matter what the condition, no matter what the situation is,
yes,
Lord, we're going to praise you. I will bless the Lord at all times. And his praises shall continually be in my mouth, even when I don't feel like it.
Yes,
when I'm hurting.
Yes,
when I don't want to.
Yes,
when I'm kind of confused, I'm going to praise your name anyway. Hallelujah. Lord, sometimes we don't even know what to pray for. But you said the Spirit, hallelujah, maketh intercession for us. Hallelujah. He's the reward of those that diligently seek him. Saints, let us praise the Lord as never before. Bind that hand of that wicked one and drive old Satan away. In the name of Jesus, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Glory to God. Lord, in this pandemic, Lord, have there been a change in our lives? Have we made a change? Lord, if we have not made a change, touch us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Our body, our soul, our mind, and our spirit, hallelujah. Lord, if we fall, you said you would lift us up with your right hand to righteousness. Lord, you're the God of all.
Yes.
You said you would hold us in the palm of your hand.
Yes.
Lord, and we thank you for that.
The
whole world belongs to you. You got the whole world in your hand. Glory to God. We praise you. We thank you. We lift you up right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Give him some thanks right now. In the name of Jesus. Things have not been always like we want them to be, Lord. But we thank you. You brought us this far. Thank you, Jesus. Help us to take a stand for you, oh God. Ask you to bless First Church. Bless the angel of this church. Bless all those that's even involved with First Church. Not only us, Lord, but your people everywhere. All over the world. The mothers, the fathers, the sisters, the brothers, the aunts, the uncles, the nieces, the nephews, the family, the friends, the foes, the enemies, the in-laws, outlaws, sinner men, women, boys, and girls. All over the world.
All over the world.
And drive old Satan away.
Yeah.
Drive him away, Lord. Lord, draw us closer to you. Hallelujah. Not by sickness, not by death, and not by accident. But draw us nigh unto you now in the name of Jesus. Encourage our hearts, Lord. Encourage our hearts, Lord Jesus. Help us to continue to pray, to strive, to be just like you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Touch and heal.
Yes, Lord.
Touch and heal right now.
Right now, Lord.
In the name of Jesus. From the top of the head even to the sole of the feet right now. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Touch and heal, oh God, hallelujah. The mind, the soul, the spirit, and the body in the name of Jesus. Lord, there's no one like you. We give you all the glory again and all the honor and all the praise. I will lift up mine eyes to the hills from which my help cometh. Oh God, my help cometh from the Lord. Glory to God, and we praise you for it right now. Thank you, Lord, for thinking about us. Your grace and mercy has brought us this far. Hallelujah. Those that are troubled, hallelujah, send deliverance, Lord. Those that are troubled, send deliverance, Lord. Turn all that fear into faith, Lord. Turn all that doubt into faith in the name of Jesus. Break down stubborn wills everywhere in the name of Jesus. We pray, Lord, and we love you. Hallelujah, we thank you. We give you honor again, oh Lord. Can't praise you enough. Can't praise you enough. Because look where you brought us from. Hallelujah. You're good, hallelujah. Always have been good and always will be God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Touch, search, and bind. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. And give us the love we need for you, for one another, oh God. Guide our footsteps. The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my guide. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. And I just want to thank you, Lord. You've been so good. You've been so good. Hallelujah. You've been so good. You've been so good. I just want to thank you, Lord. Fret not thyself.
Listen.
Because of evildoers. Neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity.
Yes.
For they shall soon be cut down like the grass.
My Lord.
And wither as a green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good.
Do good, yes.
And so shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. The grass withers, flower thereof still fades away, but the word of our God stands forever.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Missionary McIntyre, for opening us up with that lovely prayer, and Elder Scotty Welch for that scripture. Again, if you were just now joining us, welcome to First Church of God in Christ. We are so happy that you could be with us today.
Yes.
We don't believe that you are with us by chance, but we believe that there is something that is going to be said today that will encourage your heart. Right now, we are going into songs of praise. So this is our opportunity to express and show God how appreciative we are of all that he has done in our lives and everything that he is going to do. So we'll turn it over to our minister of music, Elder David Boss.
Come on, can we celebrate Jesus today? I told y'all, now if y'all were celebrating me, that would be appropriate. But let's celebrate Jesus. Yeah. The Bible says, oh, magnify the Lord with me. That means that make him big. Let's make him big, right? Bigger than our situations, bigger than our circumstance. I just have a couple of songs, short songs today. Listen, this week I thought about heaven. Saints, let's not be so attached to this world. And let's not be so complacent. And let's not be so thinking that this is all, right? COVID is not the end. We have a home in heaven, amen? We have eternal life. And I don't know about you, but I'm looking forward to see Jesus. Hallelujah. In heaven. So we're going to sing just a few songs about heaven today. You know, we were doing fine. There has to be a balance, right? Because first, back in the day, it was heaven. And we weren't so concerned about this earth. And then somebody came up with the phrase about don't be so heavenly minded that you're no earthly good. So then we went to the other side. We became so earthly good, we're not heavenly minded anymore. But I'm telling you, I've been thinking about heaven, and I want to be ready when the Lord comes. Amen. This old Albertina Walker song, it says, Lord, keep me day by day in a pure and perfect way. My God, I want to live. I want to live in a building not made by hands. Woo! Hey, Lord, keep me day by day in a pure and perfect way. I want to live. I do. I want to live in a building not made by hands. Listen, I'm just a stranger here. We didn't come here to stay. Traveling through this barren land. Lord, I know there's a building somewhere. Oh, it's a building not made by hands. I like this verse. Lord, keep my body strong. Why? So that I can do no wrong. Lord, give me grace just to run this Christian race. Oh, to the building not made by hands. Hey, Lord, keep me day by day. Hallelujah. In a pure and perfect way, I want to live. What about you? I want to live, hallelujah, in a building not made by hand. Hey, I'm looking for that day in a building not made by hand. Hey, yeah, yeah. Going to that building not made by hand. One of these old mornings. Hey, hey, woo. In a building not made by hand. And back in the day, when they would talk about heaven, one of the old mothers in the corner, she would say, oh, heaven, heaven. Singing, oh, heaven. Singing, oh, heaven. Singing, oh, heaven. Don't you want to go to heaven? Woo! Don't you want to go to heaven? Don't you want to go to heaven? My God. Don't you want to go to heaven? There is joy in heaven.
Heaven is mine.
There is joy in heaven.
Heaven is mine.
There is peace in heaven.
Heaven Woo! Is mine.
There is peace in heaven.
Heaven is mine.
Singing, oh, heaven.
Heaven
hey.
Is mine.
Singing, oh, heaven. Tell me, what do you want the Lord to say? Hey, what do you want the Lord to say? Well done, thy good and faithful servant. That's what I want the Lord to say. Tell me, what do you want the Lord to say? Hey, what do you want the Lord to say? Well done, thy good. Oh, that's what I want to. One more time. Tell me, what do you want the Lord to say? Hey, what do you want the Lord to say? Well done!
Well done! Good and faithful.
That's what I want the Lord to say.
Oh, well done!
Well done!
Well done!
Well done!
Well done!
Well done!
Well
done.
Well done.
Well done. I want to hear him say!
Well done.
I want to hear him say!
Well done.
I want to hear him say! Heaven. How many want to see Jesus? No more crying. No more dying. No more COVID-19. Yee. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing. But you can rejoice before you get to heaven. All right, I'm through. Hallelujah. Yee. Yeah.
We're all looking forward to the big graduation.
Yes,
well,
yes.
God will give us our eternal diplomas, listen, degrees, however listen, you want to look at listen. It. We're all looking for him to call our names when we meet him.
Yeah,
at least
yeah.
that's the way I picture it. I'm looking for that big graduation. And you know, it's true. When we think about hope, we have to look, build our things on eternal things. We have to look that look at like this is not our home. There's
not
an
it.
Eternity.
That's right.
I was watching Bishop J. Delano Ellis' funeral, and they were talking about how yes, he's dead or he died, but he conquered death, and now he is going on to eternity.
Listen.
So when you equate that to college, he went to the big homecoming.
Listen.
Homecoming is very big in colleges and universities. And so even though he had his home going, he went to the big homecoming. And so that's what I'm looking forward to. I work in higher education, and so homecoming is a big, big thing. That's where everybody gets together. They show their pride and their school spirit. You have the bands. So if you're big on marching bands, they're having the marching bands. Listen. Everything. It's going to be a huge, huge celebration. So this is not the end. This is not the end.
Not the end.
This is not the end.
It's not.
All right, we're getting ready for our announcements. So this evening, let us support Life Point Church at 6 p.m. for their Sunday night prayer service. The address is 400 South Abilene Avenue, Valley Center, Kansas. All who would like to come, we can meet in Valley Center at that time. So at 6 o'clock this evening, if you're not doing anything and you would like to go to God in prayer or corporate prayer, there's an opportunity for you to participate in that. All right. We have our pastors and wife church anniversary coming up. Woo! We are so lucky and so excited to have them as leaders of this church. And so due to the circumstances, we will not have a service this year, but we are asking each member and each auxiliary for $125 or whatever gift you are able to give. You can please turn in your money to Sister Connie Roberts by Sunday, October 25th. And we want to thank you in advance for support. And also, I might add, that we can show our love on social media. We can show our love on our First Church Kojic Facebook page. We can flood it that day with appreciation and stories and pictures and everything of our support and our love and our appreciation for Pastor and his wife. So even though we're not meeting together, we have several different ways that we can celebrate them. Next, if you would like to participate in giving, to those who would like to give your offering with credit or debit card, you can do so at firstkojic.com. That is 1stcogic.com. Or you can bring your offerings to the church until 12:30 p.m. Just knock on the back door and leave it in the mailbox, and a trustee will be there to receive it. Saints in the audience, please give your offerings as we leave service today, and the ushers will instruct us accordingly. Also, this Saturday, there is a Jurisdiction Virtual Leadership Academy that will be online via Zoom starting at 10 a.m. So all church leaders and missionaries or credential holders, they are encouraging you to participate in that. Again, you don't have to leave the comfort of your home. You can join online for the Jurisdictional Leadership Academy that starts at 10 a.m. And I believe they will send out text message or give you further instruction about specific details. Let us continue to pray for our sick and shut-in. And also, to end on a high note, we want to say happy birthday and happy anniversary to all those that are celebrating birthdays this week. So happy birthday and happy anniversary. We are getting ready to hear another song of praise from Elder David Boss. But before we do that, I want to introduce our speaker, which is Pastor Don L. Crowley, who will be bringing the word for us today. Let's celebrate him. We're looking forward to hearing what God has given him to encourage our hearts. And we thank God for Pastor because he's certainly keeping up with the church. Even though we are virtual, there's still a lot of work that is still being done behind the scenes, perhaps even more so to try to stay connected with our members. So, of course, he and his wife pastor together. But we're asking you to sit in prayer as Pastor Don L. Crowley will come with the word after Elder Boss gives us a song of praise.
Come on, can we say praise the Lord? Come on, let's celebrate Jesus again. Yes, yes, yes. Listen, God is just good, isn't he? In spite of everything that may be going on, the good and the bad, God is still good. And sometimes when I want to be down, and there are a few times, I'm not really a down person, but sometimes when I want to be down, I can't stay down very long, because when I think of his goodness and all the things that he has done and is doing for me in the midst of all the stuff that's going on, at the end of the day, God is just good. So this song says, whatever, and before COVID, after COVID, during COVID, the songs, they just put a praise on it. It says there's a miracle in this room, and it's got your name on it. There's healing in this room, and it's got your name on it. But you got to put a praise on it. The pastor said last week that one of the national officials used to say, we put everything else on credit. Put your blessing on credit and give God a praise. Amen. So this song says just put a praise on it. And claim your miracle and blessing during this. So Tasha Cobb is going to help me, or I'm going to help her.
With my name on it.
There's a miracle in this room. Listen to the words.
There's a healing in this room.
Can I get a little more volume, please?
And it's here for me.
There's a breakthrough. Listen.
There's a breakthrough.
And it's got your name on it.
So I'm gonna put a praise on.
Every time she says that, you should be praising him right there.
I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Hallelujah.
Somebody put a praise.
Come on, put a praise on it. Hey.
There's
a miracle in this room right here. And it's got your name on it. Some of y'all need a miracle right now.
Jeez.
There's a healing in this room. And it's got your name on it. My God. Who needs a breakthrough? There's a breakthrough. Right here, 1418. And it's got your name on it. But what are you going to do?
So I'm going to put a praise on it.
Hallelujah. That's how you get it.
Yee.
Come on and put a praise on it. Come on, come on. Oh, yeah.
I get somebody to release some praise in this room.
I love it. I love it.
I declare that wherever you are, miracles are breaking off in your house.
You know what? Come on, help.
There's a healing in this room, and it's here for me.
There's a breakthrough in this room,
got my name on it.
So what you gonna do?
So I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Woo! You better do it, come on.
I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Hey!
There's a miracle in this room with my name.
It's a personal thing with my name on it.
There's a healing in this room, and it's here for me.
Breakthrough.
There's a breakthrough in this room, got my name on it.
Woo!
So what you gonna do? So I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Oh, come on, I dare you.
I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Right here, right now.
So I'm gonna put a praise on it.
I'm gonna put a praise on it.
So I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Put your praise on your blessing.
I'm gonna put a praise on it.
My God.
Hey, so I'm gonna put a praise on it.
I hear you, I hear you.
I'm gonna put a praise on it. So I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Now to get churchy.
I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Woo!
Hallelujah.
I'm gonna put a praise.
We don't forget how to clap fast.
I'm gonna put a praise on it.
My God, put your praise on it.
I'm gonna. gonna put a
praise on it.
Yeah, before you see it, I'm gonna put a praise. Woo, my God. Yeah. I'm gonna put a praise on it. Whatever your praise is. Put a praise on it. Don't stop praising it. Put your praise.
I'm gonna put a praise on it. I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Oh, come on and praise him. Come on and praise him. Come on and praise him. Put a praise on it. Put a praise on it. Hallelujah. Whatever you're waiting for, you ought to praise him. Whatever you're looking for God to do, you ought to praise him.
Bless your name.
Don't wait till the battle is over.
Hallelujah.
You can shout now.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Well,
hallelujah.
All right now.
Hey.
Put a praise on it.
Put a praise on it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Woo.
Come on, put a praise on it. Hallelujah. It said, put a praise on it.
My God.
My God, my God. Well. Hallelujah. Uh-oh. Go ahead and praise him. Uh-oh. My God. Well, praise him. Put a praise on it. Well, praise him. My. Hey. Oh. Well, hey. Oh, my God. Hey. Oh, Baba Sidio Shando. My God. Yeah. Well, praise him. I love it. I love the praise God. That's all right, praise him. My God. Hallelujah. Yay! My God. Well, go ahead and praise him. Well, that's all right. Praise break. There's nothing wrong with it. And we say praise break. I don't know where we got that from. We say praise break, but for real, we should always be praising God. It shouldn't be no praise break. Amen? This is not my message, but Psalms 34 says, I will bless the Lord at all times. And his praise shall continually be my mouth. So therefore, I don't see praise break there. It said continually, regardless of how I think or feel, God is yet worthy to be praised. My soul shall make her boast of the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Come on, let's give God some praise.
We thank
God for each of you this morning that's here. We thank God for those who are with us on live stream on this morning. We thank God for all the things that the Lord is doing for us right now. Amen? Amen? There should be an amen there for what he's doing right now. He's keeping us right now. He's sustaining us right now. You may not feel the best in your body, but you're here. So, Lord, I thank you for that. You may say, I'm not as strong as someone else. Well, Lord, I thank you for the strength that I do have. Amen. There's always a reason to praise God. I'm going to move on because I could stay there when it's talking about praise. I know the power of praise. Amen. But we thank God. Come on, let's give God another hand. Come on. We give honor to all of our ministers and our missionaries on today, those that are here and those that are not with us on today. And we give honor to our church mother, Mother Sherrod. Amen. Thank God that God is blessing her and she's recovering and God is just blessing her spirit. Amen. Her attitude, her spirit is just so sweet. Amen. And that's half of the battle right there is your mindset. Amen. Amen. So we thank God for her. And we thank God for my wife, Sister Sherry. Amen. Let's give her a hand on today. Amen. And we thank God for all of you that's with us, as I said earlier, and those who are with us on live stream on today. We thank God for you. Have one announcement. It's already been made, but I'm going to go over it for just a second. We're asking all of our ministers and missionaries, all of our ministers and missionaries, all of our ministers and missionaries, I want it to be said that I said it, all of our ministers and missionaries, we ask that you attend our leadership conference this Saturday. The announcement has already been given. And also remember your offering. Do the very best that you can and give Sister Roberts, Connie Roberts, your offering. If you have an offering, which we hope you do, give it to Sister Roberts, and it will go into the hands that it needs to go into. Amen? Amen. Amen? Amen, amen. Mean you heard it. Amen. So be it. Amen. All right, we're going into God's word. One more time, I know we're giving God some hands, but he deserves every hand that we can give him. We have hands to praise and magnify the name of the Lord. We have a word for you on today. I don't want to be too long, but yet I don't want to rush it because it's very, very important. All of God's word is important. All of God's word. But this word today is a very serious word. It's one that's my heart. All of them are, but this one's one of my hearts, and my heart goes out to what we're going to be talking about on today. I want you to say with me, say this with me, I shall not die,
but live.
And declare
the works of the Lord.
That's found in Psalms 118 and 17. Listen. For those who are listening to us on today, again, that's Psalms 118 and 17. Try to slow down a little bit because I talk fast. The Lord. All right. I'm going to go back because I don't know what I missed, and I don't want to miss nothing on the day. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. Amen. Thank you. Let's praise God, saints. This word is going to be preached on today. Has to be preached on today. Amen. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. Psalms 118 and 17. I was inspired with this subject as I listened to Sister Crystal Aluko last Sunday as she brought a wonderful message. Let's give her another hand. Come on, come on. And her message was the steps awaited on God from Job. She gave us some profound steps. I encourage you to go back and listen to this message on YouTube. We have YouTube. So if you wasn't here, go back and listen to this message. We know Job was a wealthy man. He was upright. He was righteous in character, and he loved God. Yet God allowed the devil to destroy all his animals. Listen, I'm not going to re-preach it. She preached it last Sunday. But the devil destroyed all of his animals with the permission of God. All his possessions, everything that he had was taken. All of his children, say all. Not some left, but all. My God. And then the devil attacked his health. Amen. Even his wife, whom he loved, told him to curse God and die. Because she didn't understand what was going on. She didn't understand that my husband serves the Lord. My husband loves the Lord. My husband is upright, and this has happened to him. I don't understand this, Job. So if I was you, I would curse God and die. But Job said, you speak as a what? Foolish woman. Oh, out of all that was taken, he still held on to God. He yet held on to his integrity. Amen? He said, the Lord give it and the Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Again, what did he say? The Lord give it. The Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And as Sister Krista was sharing with us, I'm not going to re-preach this, but this just came. As she was sharing with us, if you go back and you read each chapter. And when Job makes his complaints, and he did, but he never cursed God. Through all that he went through, he literally lived the word that Ella Boss, the song that God gave Ella Boss. Regardless of how I think or feel, God is yet what? Worthy to be praised. And all that he went through, read each chapter, and he gets pretty bitter. He don't understand what's going on. He even questioned God, but he yet had enough honor and respect and reference to God that he yet gave him praise, not understanding why he was going through what he was going through. Amen? So even his wife, all his friends, all his a family, all of his possession, he had nothing. And then he did have some friends, and those friends, instead of encouraging him, they meant to. But sometimes in encouraging, we sometimes, instead of helping, we hurt. Not intentionally, but sometimes we just say the wrong things. Maybe you've never done it, but there's been times I try to encourage somebody and I said the wrong thing. There's been times I try to encourage someone and what I said was good, but the timing wasn't right. So if the timing isn't right, instead of it helping, it hurts. But I'm not going to stay there. But Job refused to give up on God. He made up in his mind, I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. Even though he does not understand why this is happening to him, he yet praise and magnify the name of the Lord. We too must trust. Here it is. We've been in the series on waiting. In the midst of this, he trusts and he waited on God. When we do not understand the difficulties we are facing, as we reminded in Job 14, 1 and 2, and it says, and she gave this scripture to us last Sunday, it said, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. He cometh forth like a flower and is cut down. He fleeteth also as a shadow, continues not. When we're born in this life, we just a few days and we full of trouble. Nothing that we done. It's just life. And after the fall of Adam, it's been like that and will be that way from now on. I didn't like this verse growing up. But in the church that I came up in, our pastor and the saints of God, they just told you what God's word said, whether you liked it or not. And so he would let us know every so often, a man born of a woman, just a few days full of trouble. It's very necessary that we get that. Because we as saints feel like if I name it, claim it, believe it, and I'm going to receive it, I'm not going to have no trouble. We're going to have trouble. Things are going to come in life. Now, I'm not going to stay here either. There's faith, but there's two sides of faith. There's faith knowing that God will do, believing that he's going to do, and he does it, and he brings us out. Read Hebrews 11 chapter. But we have to have that same faith when he don't bring us out the way we expected him to bring us out. And I'm so glad I found it, because I named it, I claimed it, I believed it, I stood on it, I prayed, I praised him, I did everything I know was right, I came to church, I love God, I love my family, I love others, I did everything right that I am aware of, and that I did not do, I repented. I asked God to cleanse me, wash me, make me more like him, and still nothing happened the way I expect it to happen. And the first thing we think is, Lord, what have I done? And then the devil comes to condemn us and try to make us feel like we're not in the will of God. But you can be in the will of God. Just read Job. We can be in the will of God, and sometimes things happen. And God allows it. Since I got to get into something on today, I can't stay here, but because I got to say what God wants me to say concerning what we're going to talk on today. But life situations, and when you do everything right and nothing works out, sometimes your mindset changes, especially when you think of what the devil is telling you. And we as saints, we deal with that also. Amen. God knew we would face some challenges, Sister Crystal, in life. Therefore, he gave us examples like Job. Different ones have shared with me. And it was Sister Crystal. God can use whoever he choose. She was willing to study. She was willing to research. She was willing to read her own Bible. She didn't go off on what someone told her. She studied her word. And in studying her word, she found out, and she shared with us, that we're going to go through. God allows some things to happen. And I was told by more than one person, they didn't know all of that was in Job. They never heard no one bring it out to that extent. But the thing is, all you got to do is read. Just say, tell your neighbor, just read. It's there. So God knew we were going to have some challenges. So therefore, he put examples like Job, and Job is not the only one, but he put examples like Job. So when things come in our life, the Bible says whatever we go through is common to man. Sister Sherry, I'm so glad I read that a few years ago, Ella Boss, because I was going through some things. I was saved and loved the Lord, Sister Moore, and I was going through some things, and I didn't think it was common to man. I thought I was the only one going through it. Oh, but then when I read God's word, he said it's common. What you're going through, others have went through. Those before you have went through, listen to this. Those that's right now is going through it, and those after you going to go through it. Then the Bible said we have a high priest who's touched by the feelings of our infirmities. Guess what? Jesus have went through what you're going through, but yet without sin. Again, God knew he was going to have some challenges in life. Therefore, he gave us examples like Job, who made up in his mind, I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. Sad to say, some people with some of these same circumstances, here we go, put your ears on. Sad to say, some people with these same circumstances, like Job had experienced, they're experiencing it. And instead of turning to God, they turn to suicide. Feeling like this is the easy way out. I didn't realize this was Suicide Prevention Month or week or whatever. We passed the week, but a month. I'm going to say month. And when Sister Crystal brought it to my attention, see, I listen when the word is going forth, no matter who's speaking, I try to listen attentively. Whether it's a child, whether it's an elder boss, whether it's the bishop, whether it's someone that you don't like, maybe someone I don't really care for. But when it comes to God's word, I try not to look at the messenger and get the message. My grandmother taught me that. She said, Don, don't look at the messenger, but get the message. So as she was speaking, she reminded us of Suicide Week a month, my mind went back as I was listening to the word. And then I was thinking, not at that time, but later on I began to think of all that Job went through. And when people go through these same circumstances, sometimes it caused them to want to commit suicide. Amen? And it's something that sometimes we run away from, but it's nothing that we should run away from. Listen to this. I'm going to give you some tips today and some signs of suicide. How to pick up a suicide victim. But because of these signs and tips I give you, you got to really listen to this. The tips I give you and the signs I give you, I'm going to go through them. Just because you see that sign don't necessarily mean they're a suicide victim. So the Lord reminded me today to make that very clear, because sometimes we hear things different. And then the devil will take, even though it's God's word, the devil will take it. And if you see that symptom or that sign, you go up the road, oh, they must be going to commit suicide. No, not necessarily. But the signs and tips I'm going to give you today is when it's to the extreme. Say extreme. When it's to the extreme and it's consistent and it becomes a state of mind, then you need to be concerned. You need to watch. You need to be on alert. And because they don't have all of the signs, that's not necessary also. It can be just that one sign, but that one sign that you see, but it's so powerful, it's so devastating that that one thing can destroy that person. So if you see that sign, just watch it. And we as saints, now this goes to everybody, but if anyone should pick up, it should be us. But we don't always pick up, but we should, because the Holy Ghost, I don't have this written down, but the Holy Ghost is a discerner. And it can discern the thoughts. We can't do it, but the Holy Ghost can discern the thoughts of an individual. Now, when God gives you these thoughts, when God gives you things, it's not for you to run and go tell everybody. I think, no, it's for you to watch. It's for you to be on alert. It's for you to pray. And if God gives it to you, you go and you try to help that person. Is that clear? Okay, if that's clear, we're going to move on. Okay, what causes, here's the first one, what causes a person to want to commit suicide? I cannot deal with each one of them and break each one down, but you just listen and watch for these signs, amen, because you never know who may be thinking in that manner. Everybody who commits suicide, I have to say this too, it's not all going through great, great things. Like drugs, that's in here. Alcohol, a home that's abusive, a marriage that is falling. I'm going to read these signs, but sometimes all of that is not going on necessarily. It can be one thing, low self-esteem. It can be that you don't feel part of everything right in your life, but you don't feel. And you allow that. And then the devils take our emotions. Listen to this. The devil takes our emotion, not just, and I know saved people, I will never share their name. I don't know why people come and talk to me like they do, but I've had people, a position in the church, one particular one came to me and said, Brother Don, there was a time in my life that I was thinking about taking my life. Going all over the world, preaching the gospel. People being blessed, saved, and delivered. I never share that person's name, and I never will. So all, not all of us, but many people deal with this spirit. And we must be real that if we pick it up or they need us, we need to be there for them. It could be the bishop. Uh-oh, this is a long live stream. It could be. You never know who it is, so look for the signs. Okay, what caused a person to want to commit suicide? Deep depression. Now remember, to the extreme. Say extreme. Deep depression. Sickness, stricken with a disease. Listen to this. Emotional swings, high and lows, unbalanced. That's why you can't get caught up in your emotions. That's why you have to get in God's word. If anybody knows about emotions, this brother knows about emotions. But God had to teach me at a young age Enjoy the dance. Enjoy the shout. Enjoy the praise. Enjoy when you feel good. But when it's not fair, you still have to trust God. You still have to believe God. And one sister came to me years ago and she said, Brother Don, it's by faith and not by feelings. I had to learn that. Because when I first got saved, I went on my feelings. Your feelings is up, down, here, there, and everywhere. We made a mistake in the church back in the day. Many times we would say, how do you feel? I feel saved. Well, what about tomorrow? How do you feel now? I don't feel saved. Do that mean I'm not saved? You just as saved today as you was yesterday. I had to learn that. And God allowed me to go through a desert storm. And I went through this storm and for a season, seemed like I could not feel the presence of God. Seemed like I couldn't get in that flow. I went through a season, believe it or not, that I wasn't dancing. I wasn't shouting. I was just holding on to God. But in that, God was letting me know I'm trying to teach you something because there's going to be times in your life that you're not going to feel me, but I'm still with you. For I said in my word, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Okay. So emotional swings, highs and lows, and unbalance, okay? Drugs and alcohol can be a cause because that plays with your emotions and all that too, all right? Rejection from family, friends, peers. You feel no connection. I don't want to get happy right here. I really don't, not right now. I knew a young man who committed suicide. I went to his service. I knew his father. They had a wonderful relationship, far as I know. They loved one another. He had some friends. He had family that loved him. But the problem was, it was brought out in the service, he felt no connection. You hear me? Not that it wasn't there, but he didn't feel the connection. Therefore, that emotion to the extreme played with him. Put yourself in this person's place. This is empathy. Have you ever been in a crowd and feel like no one, you connected to nobody? You went to another crowd, you weren't connected to that group? I don't want to say this, he's there. You came to the church feeling like you're going to feel some connection and you don't even feel it there. You go to your family and you don't feel it there. So that's very serious. And so we need to be aware of that. Okay, move on, Brother Don. Many times people who commit suicide is divorce and then the loneliness. Now you're going to feel lonely, but it's to the extreme. Amen? Must move on. Financial issues. Why would anyone commit suicide over finance? Go back during Roosevelt time, when the stock market, the depression. Go back. People doing it now too, but go back. Millionaires, rich people, jumping over bridges, jumping off from high buildings, and people's doing it now. Suicide is at a high rate right now. I meant to put down the percentage and I forgot to write it down. But go check it out. You'll be surprised. More young people now are committing suicide. People in leadership positions are committing suicide. Rich and poor are committing suicide. So why is this? Sometimes it can be divorce. Sometimes it can be loneliness. Sometimes it's financial issue. Every one day you got plenty of money. You got a beautiful home, beautiful car. You have a boat. You have everything. But the thing is, sometimes it's all on credit. And when you lose your job, you end up what? Losing everything. Sometimes you can have plenty of money. And a sickness can come. A man told me at the care home years ago, they had money. But he said the care home was eating their money up. Praise God. Money that you saved all your life for your retirement, and you're not even able to enjoy it. Many commit suicide. Move on, Brother Don. Loss of job. Move on, Brother Don. Mental pressure, which will not let up. Hopelessness. No purpose. Thank God Missionary Moore is here. She can validate what I'm saying. She works with the public. She has a degree. in helping people in this type of situation and have helped many. Amen. Ask her. She'll tell you the same thing. Hopelessness. No purpose. You feel like God, he does, but you feel like God don't love you. I know I have dealt with people that had the tendencies of suicide. I'm not just reading this off the paper. I've experienced people with suicide tendencies. I've also experienced people who wanted to take their life, and God gave me these next tips, some of these tips, how to deal with their situation. Amen? Whew. It's a sad thing. It's a sad thing. Warning signs to look for. You need to have look for these signs. Talking about wanting to die. Looking for ways of taking their life. Be able to know these signs. And if it's continually, remember, if it's consistent, if it's to the extreme, you need to pay attention to it. I've had friends, more than one, of people I knew who wanted to commit, and they was talking about dying. I talk about dying too sometimes, but to talk about it all the time, something's wrong. They wanting to die and not live, something's wrong. That's not natural. We all have those moments, but the state of mind, that's not normal. Feeling hopeless, having no purpose. That's another sign. Listen to this one. Feeling trapped or being in unbearable pain. You in your body, I've dealt with people, so I understand because they shared with me how they felt. You feel entrapped in your body, and you feel like you can't get out. And it's not all necessary physical pain, but the pain of what you're feeling on the inside is so great, it's so unbearable until you want to get out of it. Am I right, Sister Moore? And you don't know how to get out of it. You try to do what people tell you to do, but you still find yourself feeling like, I can't get out of this. Oh, move on. Feeling like they are a burden to others. I can't tell nobody because it's just going to be a burden. Amen? Move on. Increasing use of alcohol and drugs. Maybe dealing with drugs or alcohol, but now it's an increase. And that stuff can take you here, there, and everywhere. One minute you're high, one minute you're low, one minute whatever. And then after, I've even seen people who affect, I had a friend, my God, his mother even told me to share his name and try to help people, which I won't do that part. But the man messed his mind up with drugs, with alcohol. And Sister Angie, when he stopped using the drug, wasn't always using them at the time. There was a time in his life, I don't think he was using them as much, but the damage had already been done. And the damage is in the brain. And the brain is your thinking capacity. Am I right? So there's days I talked to him and he wasn't doing nothing, but the mind was just messed up. Ooh, it hurts. It hurts. And you're trying to help. You're trying to be there for them, but still be there for them. You can be the one who saved their life. Don't lead them that way by themselves. Praise God. But be there for them. Acting anxious and agitated, abusive, or reckless to themselves. It's not always cutting yourself. It's not always in that sense, but you're just abusive. You don't take care of yourself. You don't care about yourself. You don't keep yourself up continually. I don't care. Have a don't care attitude about yourself. That's not normal. The Bible said if you have your right mind and in your right mind, he said every man who have his right mind or woman, they're nourished. They take care of themselves. Then he said love your neighbor like you love yourself. So you're abusive to yourself, you're going to be abusive to others. But right now we're talking about that person who has these problems. Listen, this is another sign. Sleeping too little or too much. Too little, not getting enough sleep, or you just sleep all the time. You sleep all the time because you don't want to deal with life situations. Ooh, I wish I could break all these down. Withdrawn or feeling isolated. There it is. Not connected with others. You have a withdrawing. And this is always, now some people have this type of personality. So you have to figure out, is this person's personality? Now, if that's their personality, that's different. But if that's not them, that's why you got to get to know people. Some people just withdraw, but they're not suicidal. Some people are introverts. They're not suicidal. They enjoy being by themselves. They don't want a whole lot of friends, so they're not suicidal. But if you find a person who's like Ella Boss, a people person, love people, love to mingle with people, and all at once he get quiet. He always to himself. He don't want to talk to me no more. He always, what you doing, Ella Boss? I'm just here. Where you going? I ain't going nowhere today. Then the next day, I'm still not going nowhere. Call him next week, I'm still not doing nothing. You going to church? No, I ain't going to church. You going, what else you like to do? You going to your boys' game? Uh-uh, I ain't going to that game. I'm just going to drop them off. When you see patterns like that change in a person, you need to check it out. Amen? Displaying extreme mood swings, we talked about. Change of character, I just said that. Extremely negative concerning life. These are signs. Don't feel loved or accepted by others or God. Exceptionally low self-esteem, you feel like I don't matter. People need to know that they matter. Amen? If you're talking to a suicide victim, you need to let them know that they matter. And then inner conflict, within themselves, which they feel like they have no one they can share with. There's nothing like inner conflict. What is inner conflict? It's an inner problem that you have in our inner situation. You can look good. You can look fine. You can have plenty of money. Everything on the outside is right. That's why it's called inner. It's inside of you, and it's causing inner conflict. And no one knows it because they know you as a happy-go-lucky person, always dancing, always shouting, always this and that. But you have inner conflict. These things have to be deal with. I know about inner conflict because I was one of them. I was dancing. No one run and said he wanted to commit suicide. I've never wanted to take my life. Let's get that right. Amen? But I can relate. I know about inner conflict because I had inner conflict. And I was dancing. I was shouting. I had a wonderful wife. This is since I've been married. I got married 21. I had beautiful children. I have a beautiful church. I have good friends. But I still had that inner conflict. And it was a thorn in the flesh. And I wanted God to remove that thorn, but he did not remove the thorn. But he taught me that my grace is sufficient. But the thing is, you have to learn how to deal with your thorn, because your thorn is not going nowhere. And guess what? All of us have one. As much faith as you have a thorn. We all have thorns. But we're not to allow that thorn to dominate us. Because greater is he that's in me than he that is in the... Okay, we got... Okay, now here we go. How can we help? Listen to this. How can we help those who are dealing with suicide tendencies? You know the warning signs? You know what causes it? Now, how can we help those who are dealing with suicide tendencies? Here we go. Speak purpose in their life. Tell them they matter. Tell them, not somebody else. Don't tell them mama love you and this one love you and that one. That's okay. But tell them that you love them. Tell them that you matter to me. It may not change things overnight, but it will at least help keep many of them alive, that they matter to you. I've had to tell individuals that. My wife had told individuals that. We love you. Me and Sherry, we love you. We're there for you. We love you just like you are. We love you with your addiction. We love you with your situation. Don't approve of it, but we love you. And it will cause them to live, woo, and not die. Tell them that they are valuable. You can tell them they're valuable to their mother and sister and all this, but tell them that they're valuable to you. This is a time you have to make it personal, because they look at why you talking. They say, yeah, but that one and this one and this one, this one. But you have to say, I value you. You have to be like the man that me and Brother Taiwan met one day. We was out doing street ministry, and we went out, and I said, not Taiwan, I said, God loves you. He said, that's what I hear all the time. I want to know, do you love me? And then I said, brother, I love you. Okay, move to the next point. Be a friend. Build a relationship which will take some time and effort. Be patient with them and remember they're in a crisis. Amen? This is real. Next point, encourage them to see the positive side of life. Now, you have to show them the positive because they can't see it. You got to call it out and try to help them to see it. Now, you're not going to be able to help everybody, but you could be able to help somebody. Encourage them to see the positive side of life. And the scriptures give us this. Teach them how to think on things that are true, things that are good, things that are good report, things that are lovely, and then teach them not to abuse or to harm themselves. Because again, you are somebody. Tell them you're too beautiful for that. You're too handsome for that. You have too much potential for that. Speak into their life. Tell them who they are. Teach them how to love and how to nourish themselves and how to take care of themselves. Then also, here's another point, teach them how to forgive themselves and others. I've had people share with me certain situations in their life. And that person, people don't like to hear me say this, that person may now never come to you and ask you to forgive them. That one that I'm talking to right now on live stream, it may have been your father. It may have been your mother. I hate to say this. It may have been somebody in the church. But you got to forgive them. Because if you don't forgive them, that thing will eat you up. That thing will destroy just unforgiveness. Yes, it was done. We cannot deny that. And I will not tell you to deny that. But you have to forgive them. Jesus on the cross, they abused him. They spit on him. They did all manner of things against him. And Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. But Ella Stidham, I've told many people that, especially Christians. And Christians have told me that was Jesus. I said, okay, that was Jesus. What about Stephen? They stoning him. They throwing rocks on him, at him. And Stephen looked up. And he said, Father, don't hold this to their charge. In other words, forgive them. Woo! And as they were stoning him, as they was kicking him, he looked up. He said, I see Jesus on the right-hand side of God. And he's standing up. Hallelujah. But he wouldn't have seen that if he had not forgave them. Joseph, we're talking about Joseph. Sold into slavery. Put into a pit. Woo! Rejected of his brothers. But yet he forgave them. That's why Joseph was able to go on with life. Not that he didn't hurt. Not the things that he wasn't going through. Not that he didn't feel the emotions of loneliness. Feel the emotions of where my family at. Feel the emotion of the things that you go through in rejection. He felt all of that. But he knew he had God on his side. So you have to learn to forgive. Amen? Forgive. Forgive. Say forgive. You have to forgive that one who has hurt you. Forgive. So, and forgiving, God will do great and he will do mighty things for you. Then, recommend professional counseling and treatment if needed. Try to help them. And if you can't help them, send them to some counseling and still be with them. I told one of my friends, I said, I'll go with you. Whatever program you have to go to, I go with you. But you need to get some professional help. Amen? So send them to some professional help if they need it. Now, sometimes just being a friend and doing these things I share with you, they won't necessarily have to go. I had a young man. I worked with him. They brought him into my room when they called me into an office. I won't go into all the details. And they said, I want you to see, can you help this young man? And I gave him the steps. I didn't even know the steps. I was just doing these things. Now that I look back, these are the things I was doing, some of them. And in that, that man lived and not die. He was going to take his life, and they would allow him. He would come to my room, and we would just talk. I have to hear the same thing over and over and over, over and over and over. But that's needed because that was the way he relieved. That's the way he vented. Amen. Here's the next one. There it is. You must have a listening ear, which I have problems with that sometimes. You have to have a listening ear. You don't have to always have the answer. Sister Moore, I'm confessing, I'm a fixer. If I know the problem that you have, and I want to tell you what to do to fix it. I don't know all the answers, but if I know the answer, I want to tell you, whether it's my wife, whether it's you, whether it's Ella Boss, if I think I know the answer, I want to tell you the answer to the problem. But sometimes they don't want, no. Right then, at that time, they need the answer. But first, before they can get the answer, they need someone to vent to. They need someone to talk to. They need somebody to get it off from them. And then when they get it off from them, then they're ready, maybe, for an answer. I'm still working on that. So the thing is to have a listening ear, especially in situations like this. And I'm almost through. The next thing is check on them regularly. I had a friend who had suicide tendencies, talked about it time after time. And I knew he had a lot of this stuff that I've had written down, these tips. And I seen them all, and they was obvious. And I knew that he could do that. And since I knew it, I said, can I have a key? I said, someone needs a key to check on you. I asked for a key. At that time, I told Sherry later, but I didn't even tell Sherry. I didn't tell nobody, and you'll never know. So I finally got a key. And when we talk about, and sometimes he'd talk about suicide more than other times. And sometimes I knew he was one step of doing it. And there was times I would go to the apartment. And as I was walking up, going to the door, I said, Lord, please don't let me find this boy. Amen? So the thing is, you have to check on them regularly. And then when you check and you see all is well, speak life. You matter. You're valuable. I love you. I'm here for you. I can shake you. I can shake you where you may feel like you're going. But I'm here for you. Check on them regularly. And that person, won't call no name, but that person now is doing fine. Amen? Then recommend Jesus to them. And let them know that he's the best friend they could ever have. And anytime I do counseling, anybody who knows me, if you want to call it counseling, I always tell people, whether you do it or not, I recommend Jesus. I don't care what the situation is, and whoever listened to me today, I don't care what the situation is, I recommend Jesus to you. Because he will be a friend that stick closer than a brother. He will walk with you. He will guide you. He will teach you. He will comfort you. When you feel lonely, he will let you know I'm here with you. But you have to trust in him. And that's why, Ella Boss, I said, Jesus, friend of mine, he is my best friend. So I recommend Jesus, whoever you are today, I say to you, live and not die. So you can stay here on this earth and declare the works of the Lord. I recommend Jesus to you. And then we close in Jeremiah 29:11 says, and this is God speaking. He said, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Therefore, you must speak this to yourself. And whoever I'm speaking to on the day, it may be someone even in this room, who have tendencies, or you're dealing with tendencies, or the enemy tries to come and whisper that into your ears. You don't have to tell nobody, but I want you to repeat this after me. I shall not die, but live. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. God bless you on the day. God wants you to stay here on this earth so you can declare the works of the Lord. Whoever you are on today, as we close, we're going to pray for you on today. You heard all the things that we said on today. This was not an easy lesson. This is not a lesson that I really wanted to bring. But I brought it because I'm concerned about whoever I'm talking to on today. I know that who I'm speaking to goes beyond here at First Church. I want to let you know, I don't know you personally, but I want you to know whoever I'm speaking to today that you matter. I want you to know that Brother Don loves you. Not Elder Crowley, not Pastor Don. Brother Don, I am your brother. I am your friend. And I love you. I want you to know that your life, it matters. I want you to know that you are valuable. I want you to know that the feelings that you feel, I didn't have time to really explain everything, but I want you to know that the feelings that you feel, they are real. But I say to you today to deal with those feelings. Deal with those emotions. Go to a pastor. Go to a first lady. Go to a friend. Go to that person that can help you. If you don't know who can help you, go to someone that can suggest and advise you to go to someone who can help you. But get you some help, because you matter to God. And God wants you to live. God do not want you to take your life. Your life is the most valuable thing that you have. And when God gets ready, he knows how to call you home. God will give you the strength. God will give you the strategy. God will give you whatever you need today. Whatever you need today, God will give it to you. We're going to pray, but I want to say to you before I pray, in doing this and everything that I said God will do, you have to learn how to wait on him. It's a process. You're not going to feel like flying on tomorrow and you're going everything just gone. You may have to deal with it for a while, but the thing is, know that God is with you. And then he can do things instantly, however he chooses, but know that God is with you. Now, Lord, we just thank you for your many blessings. We ask the congregation to stand. And if anyone wants special prayer on the day, just stand where you are. You don't even have to raise your hand today. You know who you are. And if you need special prayer, just pray along with us on today. Now, Lord, we just thank you for your many blessings. We thank you for your goodness and for your mercy and for your outstretched hand. Lord, we take this subject and what you gave us today very seriously, oh God. Because, Lord, we know if it wasn't for your grace, life situations have hit all of us, God, that there have been times we may not want to commit suicide, but we thought we was ready to go to heaven. And we didn't want to go to heaven so much because we just want to be with you, but we wanted to escape what we're going through here on this earth, oh God. But Lord, your way is not the easy way out. Your way is the way of showing us how to live, showing us how to deal with life circumstances, oh God. For you said that man born of a woman just a few days full of trouble. So, Lord, we know that with that, Lord, you promised that you would be with us. So, God, we ask that you strengthen us and cleanse us, that you wash us and make us whole. Lord, I ask today, if you're not saved, you can ask God right now, Lord, come into my life. Be Lord and Savior of my life. Lord, I need you on the day. I reach out to you, God, because I need you right now, God. Lord, there's hope in you. There's peace in you. The brother said there's joy in you. The songs on the day said you have heaven. It's for us and it's prepared for us, God. But Lord, we must prepare for it, oh God. So help us, oh God. Cleanse us and wash us and make us whole. And Lord, I shall not die, but I shall live and I shall declare the works of the Lord. Now, God, we thank you, we praise you, and we magnify you in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. We're going to ask Ella Boss to give us our closing song, and then Ella Welch will dismiss us on today. We send the First Church as you go out. You can give your offering as the ushers assist you out at the door. God bless you, Ella Welch. David, Ella Boss will do the closing song, and then Ella Welch will dismiss us.
It's an old song I used to say.
Throw out the lifeline, throw out the lifeline. Someone is sinking today. Throw out the lifeline, throw out the lifeline. Someone is drifting away. Oh, throw out the lifeline, throw out the lifeline. Someone is drifting away. You just throw out the lifeline, throw out the lifeline. Someone is sinking today. One more time, just throw out the lifeline, throw out the lifeline.
away. You just throw out the lifeline. Throw out the lifeline. Someone is sinking today.
Lord, we thank you for the emphatic word of the Lord that declares, I shall live and not die, and declare the works of the Lord, for the entrance of thy word giveth light. Now unto him that's able to keep us from falling, unto him that's able to keep us from going astray, unto him that's able to present us faultless before the presence of his glory, to him alone be glory, majesty, dominion, and power. Thank you again, Lord, for Elder Don Crowley and the word of the Lord. In Jesus' name, God, I pray, dismiss it from here, but, Lord, never from your presence. Amen and amen.
Throw out the lifeline. Throw out the lifeline. Someone is drifting away.